Hey guys, Jacob over here. Welcome to the first iteration of Brew Talk for the 2018 Milwaukee Brewers season. And man, this has been a very long time since I made a Brew Talk episode. If you remember, my first ever video I made was back in July of 2017 when I made the first ever Brew Talk episode. And man, what a journey it's been since then. We've done plenty of things, from the Packers to the Bucks, to the Brewers, to the Badgers. We've done everything in Wisconsin sports here at Over Sports, and that's what my goal was. My goal when I started out with these talk videos, when I started to create this channel, was to make a channel where I could talk about everything Wisconsin sports related. And now my next goal is going to be to expand that even further, where I can talk more nationally to expand my audience. When I started this channel, I had about 59 subscribers, and now we're up to 641, so it's been quite a build-up since then. And I'm really excited to see where this channel goes in the future, but right now I'm excited to get back to my roots here. I love the Brewers, I love talking about the Brewers, and I'm excited to get Brew Talk going again. So without further ado, let's talk about the Brewers. So the Brewers last season finished 86-76, and just fell one game short of the NL wild card. They would have played the Rockies in the wild card game, but unfortunately they weren't able to make it on the last day. So, but with their success last season, they carry a lot of expectations into this season, and they addressed those expectations this offseason by signing Lorenzo Cain and trading for Christian Yelich. And it's been a very eventful offseason for the Brewers, even though it's been slow at times. Those two acquisitions were among the two most noteworthy in the offseason this season for the entire MLB. It was a very slow offseason for the MLB and baseball in general. And there are still guys out there who are who are more than worthy of playing baseball this season on an opening day roster that have not been signed. The Brewers did not address, what I found interesting is that the Brewers this offseason did not address their pitching, which I thought they were going to do, but in my opinion, I will go with it because I know that David Stearns knows what he's doing, and I kind of understand his logic behind it. I don't think that this is the year for the Brewers to just go all in and go for it, because the Cubs are more than equipped enough to win the NL Central this year. But I do think the Brewers are going to make the playoffs, and I do think that it would be wise to maybe consider an acquisition at some point this season, maybe during the trade deadline. They are going to get Jimmy Nelson back this midsummer, I believe, so that will be like a midseason acquisition in itself. We'll have to see what happens. But this Brewers team, don't sleep on their pitching, even though it is thin. They finished 9th in team ERA last season. I do believe in Chase Anderson. I don't believe last season was a fluke for him. I believe in Zach Davies. I believe in Drew Holes. So we'll see what happens with this Brewers pitching staff. They are thin, they are young, but I think that they have a chance to be very good again this offseason, or this Brewers season. So we'll have to see what happens. Overall, though, I do think the Brewers are going to make the playoffs. If you watched my MLB predictions video, I picked them to be the first NL wild card, and I picked them to beat the Cardinals in the wild card game before eventually falling in 6 games to the Los Angeles Dodgers in the NLDS. So, but you know, if you get into the MLB playoffs, it's a crapshoot. You don't know what's going to happen. So once you get in, you have just as good a chance to make the playoffs as anyone, in my opinion. So with that, those are my opening day thoughts. I'm really excited for this season. It's been a very long off season for the Brewers, and I'm sure that everyone's excited to get back into the swing of things. So anyways, guys, let me know what you guys think of the Brewers in the comment section below. How good are they going to be this year? What is their record going to be? In my personal opinion, I didn't pick records in the predictions video, but I'm going to go with the Brewers having a record of 87-75 this year and making the playoffs as the first wild card. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe. Follow me on Twitter at @obersports41512, and I'll see you guys next time.